Good afternoon. In just 1 hour, three more Sydney Council areas will be plunged into tighter lockdown restrictions as the state records 345 cases today. These are the nine LGAs where stronger rules are already in place. From 5 p.m, the Bayside, Strathfield and Burwood Council areas will be added. The stricter rules include masks at all times outdoors, a 5 kilometre travel limit and only a small list of essential workers can leave their LGA. And the Premier has warned residents of the Inner West and Camden councils they could be the next to fall under these tougher restrictions. Lauren Tomasi joins us now from Arncliffe in the Bayside Council area. Lauren, people there are already clearing the streets.
They are, Lizzie, and the testing clinic, on the other hand, is certainly picking up business. In the last few minutes, we've seen car after car coming in. It was quiet this morning, but since that news that this is one of three councils going into that harsher lockdown, cars have just been teaming in to get tested. Of course, Bayside, one of three of the LGAs going into this tougher lockdown, also Burwood and Strathfield. So from 5 o'clock tonight, less than an hour's time, our residents here will be in a 5 kilometre radius kind of bubble. They won't be able to go more than 5 kilometres when it comes to shopping and exercise. Only one person per household will be able to leave to do the shopping. Masks will be mandatory everywhere except for inside your house. So certainly tougher restrictions and a very limited list of authorised workers able to leave their LGAs. It comes after another surge in cases, 345 cases today, and sadly a further two deaths. Once again, there has been a big number of cases out infectious in the community. And there is concern for regional New South Wales. There was some good news today that Tamworth hasn't recorded any further cases, but there is further concern for that Newcastle region.
Unfortunately, the same isn't the case for Hunter and New England, where there's been a number of cases overnight. And as a response to that, New South Wales Health has recommended that those local government areas which are currently in lockdown, including the Hunter and the Upper Hunter areas, will be extended by another week.
When it comes to testing, just a phenomenal effort by everyone across New South Wales. Just under 152,000 tests in the past 24 hours. That's by far and away the biggest record that we've seen. And you can see why people are turning out, trying to do the right thing. But Lizzie, now less than an hour until those new restrictions come in for a further three council areas.
Lauren Tomasi there in Arncliffe. And the ACT has been plunged into lockdown, ending more than a year of COVID-free life for the territory that's surrounded by New South Wales. Let's bring in politics reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jono, talk us through the details.
Lizzie, it's one confirmed case and it's led to a shutdown across the ACT for a week starting in 56 minutes. This is the second COVID lockdown in the nation's capital, and there will be four reasons to leave your home. They are work, medical, including getting vaccinated, buying groceries, and for up to 1 hour's exercise per day. The phrase from authorities, "do not panic buy," meant little to those who already were. Have a look at these pictures. And news just into, we have limits on toilet paper sales here in the ACT now as well. As for the case, it is a man in his 20s who was infectious in the community for almost a week. You can see the exposure sites here. He'd been to a bar, a church, and a major shopping centre. Health officials believe it's the Delta variant this man has and expect it originated in Sydney. Genomic sequencing events results will be expected tomorrow. Authorities this afternoon would not say whether or not this man had been to a COVID hotspot.
It's not crucial to our immediate response. What's crucial is where the individual was, where the exposure sites are, who the close contacts are.
Do not make this about an individual and about the wrongs they've done before we can get all of that information and make the community.
So that contact tracing continues, but this lockdown has ramifications not just for the hundreds of thousands of people who live in the ACT, but the nation's parliament. It rises today for a week, and already the options for leaving were limited. MPs from Sydney could return but would have to quarantine if they wanted to come back to the ACT. Melburnians would have to quarantine on return home. Travel into Queensland and Tasmania was still okay, but the lockdown has thrown into doubt the next sitting of parliament in just over a week. Some MPs have already made the dash back home before the 5 p.m. lockdown.
I'm very concerned about the situation here in the ACT. If Mr. Morrison had not failed, absolutely failed Australia in his job of the vaccination rollout. This might have been avoided.
Some of us have got young kids to get home to, so it makes a lot of sense.
The sooner we get to a 70% vaccination space, the better we'll be.
But that 70%, Lizzie, that will be months away.
New Zealand has revealed its roadmap out of COVID. Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has detailed how the country will reopen, using Australia as an example of what not to do. The Prime Minister indicated the country could welcome vaccinated travellers from countries with low cases of COVID by next year. Vaccinations remain a priority, the rollout expanding to all eligible age groups from next month. The World Health Organization will soon begin testing three drugs used to treat other diseases to see if they can help fight COVID. The Director General says they will be brought into the next phase of the organization's global research program.
Solidarity Plus will test three drugs: artesanate, a treatment for severe malaria; imatinib, a drug for certain cancers; and infliximab, a treatment for immune system disorders.
The drugs were selected by an independent panel of experts, with the trial involving thousands of researchers in hospitals across 52 countries. Four mystery COVID infections are causing concern for Victorian contact tracers, with no clues as to how three people in two Melbourne households caught the virus. The state's recorded 21 new local cases today, as well as two infections from Sydney women who flew to Melbourne on Monday without a valid permit. They've since been moved into hotel quarantine.
Pressure mark when we continue to see people coming through with the wrong documentation, with what 90 people moved into hotel quarantine, a whole heap turned back. It's a waste of everybody's time. What on earth they thought they were doing, I can only speculate.
Businesses in Victoria will be given a helping hand during the seven-day lockdown extension, with a further $367 million in funding committed by the state and federal governments. Well, as Sydney is locked in a COVID struggle, the government has announced all types of grants and financial assistance for businesses and people who are out of work. But the reality is not so great. Joining me is Nick Callis, the owner of the Metropole Cafe in the QVB in the city. Thanks for talking to us, Nick. You've applied for assistance and it's been approved, but still no money.
Still nothing. Nothing's come up. We called the other day. It took quite a few hours to get through when we did finally get through. And we were told, yes, it's being processed. It shouldn't be too long. That's all the information we got.
And Nick, talk us through your situation. When was the last time you made a coffee or you made any money?
Okay, look, we closed from just as the lockdown started, which was the end of June. We had ordered all this stock for the weekend. So we were, we didn't know. You've got to order days in advance. And then all of a sudden we've been told there has to be a lockdown. A lot of people don't realise, unless you've had your own business, you don't realise how much everything costs. And the thing is now, it's like when it finally opens, how do we catch up? Everybody wants their money. All the suppliers have to be paid. The landlords definitely want their money as well. So I'm feeling it right now.
Oh, absolutely. Now, Nick, the longer this goes on, where does this leave you and where does it leave your business?
Well, that's the thing. We don't know. Are we open in October, November, December, January? And being in a prime location in the city, our overheads are quite high. Even, if we do end up getting a reduced rental, that's still very high for where we are. So it's a matter of how long can we bleed for and are we able to recover from this? Because at the end of the day, we're selling coffees, and a lot of the sales are $4 sales. And people say, oh, you can open and you can do takeaway. When there's no people around, who are you going to sell to?
Yeah. Are you paying rent now, Nick? And what do you need from the government? What do you need right now?
Well, look, we're negotiating at the moment because we don't know how long this is going to go for. There's a lot of mental health issues going on now and a lot of deaths that aren't being reported if they're not COVID deaths, and a lot of stress and pressure on a lot of our friends that we know that are also in the industry. So, we just want answers and support to help keep us going, because at the end of the day, if all these businesses end up closing, there's going to be a lot of unemployment and there's going to be a lot of ongoing issues. So it's not going to be, just a quick fix, that's for sure.
And Nick, you need to know that money is coming. You need a date, don't you?
Exactly. We need to know. We need to plan. We've been there for 18 years. And that's why I don't usually, you know, I don't normally whinge and complain. We're fairly good operators, and we have to weigh up now is when we do finally reopen, how much losses are we sort of have been accumulated, and can we keep going?
Well, thank you so much, Nick. Don't think that you're whinging or complaining. You are just saying it how it is, and we are so grateful that you've given us your time this afternoon.
Yeah, well, thank you, Lizzie. Thank you for your time also.